Good morning, dear student. In a last lecture, we have learned what is loader, what are the four functions associated with loader, general scheme loader, and a compile and go loader. In a today's lecture, we will learn what is an absolute loader. Translation, everything will be done outside the loader. All the OBJ file will be accepted by an absolute loader and it loads it into the main memory. The advantage of this system is that as retranslation is not required and translation is done outside the loader, therefore one source program can have a different subprograms in it which can be written in a different languages, and the translator of those particular languages will convert it in its OBJ file and pass it to an absolute loader. Now, if the loader ka task is just to load the program into a main memory and other things are taken care of by an assembler or a programmer, then how loader gets this information? So remember, in absolute loader, the assembler passes all this information in the form of a cards. So there are two types of a card used in an absolute loader. First card is called as a text card and second card is known as a transfer card. Now, what is text card and what is a transfer card? So, as mentioned to you, assembler perform everything. Translation is done by assembler. Relocation is also done by assembler. So, assembler knows that where that program should be loaded, at which memory location. So, assembler transfer all the machine instruction along with its core location. Core location means where to load that particular instruction in a card, and that card is called as a text card. Means, in short, you have to remember, text card is nothing but a card where all the machine instruction along with their core address or along with their assigned core location is provided using a text card. Whereas in a transfer card hold the entry point of the program. Now, what is the meaning of entry point? See, once all the instruction is loaded into an memory where the control should pass, means once everything is loaded, let's assume that I have one program from location 100 to 200. If I insert all those 100 to 200 location instruction, now where my control should pass, at which location? So that location will be mentioned in a card known as a transfer card. So assembler pass two cards to the loader, absolute loader, and those cards are text card and transfer card. Now all these text card and transfer card are always a 80 column format. Now what does this 80 column hold, and how to identify that which card is text card and which card is a transfer card? So column number 1 in both card always indicate type of a card. If 0 is printed in that particular column number 1, you will say it is a text card. If 1 is printed, you will identify it is a transfer card. Okay, now as I told you that text card contains the instruction, actual instruction that needs to be loaded along with its memory location. Ki ye particular instruction kaun se address pe store karni hai, wo hame text card batata hai. So let's assume if I have one instruction, let's say add A register B, and if this instruction should get stored at location 100. Okay, so 100 is the location, so that location means address, and it will be mentioned at the column number 325, and my actual instruction will be placed at the card or column number 8 to 72. Okay, 73 to 80 is always a card sequence number. The same thing or the same column numbers are there, 1 to 80. 73 to 80 column number is always indicating card sequence number. Now, transfer card hold only the address that where the control should pass after entering or after inserting all the instruction. Means text card will have everything, but transfer card will have only the memory location. So that memory location or that particular address will be stored at location 325. So remember, whether it is text card or whether it is transfer card, address is always mentioned in the column number 3 to 5. 73 to 80 is always a card sequence number. If card type is 0 means it is text card. If card type is 1 means it is a transfer card. It is very very important question as far as exam is concerned. Okay, so once a card used by an absolute loader is done, the next is how assembler provide this card and how loader loads the instruction into an main memory. So next is design of an absolute loader. See, loader loads the program into an memory, but with the help of a cards which is provided by a assembler. So we have already learned this two type of a card. So the first step in design of absolute loader is to initialize the process and read the card. Once the card is readed, the next step is to find out which type of card it is. If it is transfer card, means everything is loaded, now pass a control to the new location. But if it is a text card, means we have to actually load an instruction into that particular memory location. So one variable cursor location or cur location is used, and what value it holds? It holds the value which is mentioned in the column number 3 to 5. As I have already told you that 3 to 5 holds the address. Agar hame instruction place karni hai, to bhi 3 to 5 address hum log use karenge. Means location 3 to 5 mein hi address hamara mention rahega. Even if it is an entry point, the address is always placed at the location 3 to 5. So cursor location is one variable which set the value or which holds the value which is mentioned in the column number 3 to 5. Once the cursor location is set, the card will be readed. Now, card will get read. Now, if the card type is 1, meaning is what? It is a transfer card. So, if it is a transfer card, what does it indicate? That everything is loaded. Now, simply set the entry point or transfer the control to that particular location. Now, where that location is mentioned, we have already stored it in a cursor location. So if a type is 1, means it is a transfer card, therefore transfer the control to the location which is mentioned in the particular variable, and which is that variable cursor location. But if card type is 0, what does it indicate? It indicate that it is a text card. Now, if it is a text card, means it holds the instruction. So, if it is an instruction, the first thing is to find out how long that instruction is, or what is the length of that instruction. And length of an instruction is always mentioned in a text card at column number 2. So this column number 2 indicates how many bytes of that part of information that particular instruction hold. So if the card is a text card, set one variable, that is LNG, to the count which is mentioned in the character or in the column number 2. Okay, so if my instruction is of 10 byte, what will be the value of LNG? It will be 10. And then that much amount of that much byte of information will be loaded into the memory. But from where it will be loaded? Actual instruction is placed from location 8 to 72. So once we know that total length of that particular instruction is this much, then we will insert that much memory, or we will insert that particular instruction from location 8 to 72 to the cursor location. Is it clear? I will repeat once. If the card is type 0, means it is text card. If it is text card, identify total length of an instruction. Once you know total length of an instruction, set it with one variable, that is LNG, and move that much byte of data from which location? From location 8 to 72. To the location. हमें अभी address पे move करना है, but actual address is stored at location 3 to 5. Therefore, move to the location 3 to 5. But 3 to 5 is mentioned or set as a variable, that is cursor location. Therefore, move it to the location, that is curlo. Okay. So this is what a design of an absolute loader. Now, what is the advantages of the system? Advantages of the system is, as this assembler is not a part of a loader, therefore retranslation is not going to required every time. Second thing is, it is possible to write a source program with a multiple programs and with a multiple languages. But the disadvantage of the system is, as a allocation task is done by a programmer, it is a compulsion for a programmer to know the memory management properly. Similarly, if a subroutine linkage concept is used, then programmer must specify the addresses wherever the external variables are used. Thank you. I hope you understood the concept of an absolute loader. The important question as far as theory is concerned is design of absolute loader, and the best book for it is J. Donovan, as I have already mentioned it. And the MCQ pattern exam questions are concerned, the advantages, disadvantages, and which task is going to perform by whom, that is the very, very important question for an MCQ pattern. Thank you.